Today's tutorial is the first one in a series of videos dedicated to 2D game art techniques. They cover the main tools I use in my work as a 2D game artist. In this video, we're going to learn the main tools we have at our disposal to preserve our game's assets, our fat channels, at all times. As game artists, we need to be very careful about our asset silhouette. When we paint digitally, the edges of an object may blend a bit with the background. Their opacity may vary in places. This is just fine for concept art or illustration, where the final result is a still image. In games, however, the background will scroll or change under our assets. If we mess up any of our assets' transparency, it will be visible while playing. Thus, most of the time, we want our assets to be drawn within a closed shape, with a sharp and consistent border. That's exactly the type of edge vector software generates. In both raster and vector software, there is one extremely useful and flexible tool that helps to preserve an object's alpha at all times. It's called clipping masks. A clipping mask basically limits the mask of a layer to a parent layer, which is put below it. Let me show you. Here I'm clipping the layer 2 to layer 1. Whatever I paint on layer 2 is masked by the content of layer 1. There are three ways to clip a layer to another in Photoshop. First of all, you can keep the Alt key down and put your cursor between two layers in the Layers panel. When your cursor changes to an arrow pointing down, just click, and boom, you have a clipping mask. You can also select any amount of layers and press Ctrl-Alt-G to toggle layers clipping on or off. Lastly, you can right-click on the layer's name and click on the Create Clipping Mask option. Now that we know how to use clipping masks, let's talk about the options we have to maintain our asset silhouette consistency. There are four simple ways to maintain a sharp silhouette for your assets in Photoshop. You can, first of all, use a vector shape layer or a smart object and clipping masks. Solution number two, you can use a group mask or a vector mask. And three, you can lock the layer's alpha. All three options work well depending on the situation. Let's take a look at each of them. Technique number one, using a base layer. This approach is pretty straightforward. You just want to set up a base layer that will serve as your alpha mask, and you only paint on layers clipped to it. It is a good technique if you want to use a flexible vector shape that you can edit whenever you need as a base. You can also use clipping masks in conjunction with smart objects in Photoshop. Photoshop can't import external vector shape apart from Illustrator layers. However, it can import EPS vector files as smart objects. Sometimes I use Inkscape to draw complex vector shapes like icons. They can't be edited anymore once they're dropped in Photoshop, but they can always be changed later. Technique number two, using a mask. Masks are simply secondary alpha channels applied to a layer or a group. They limit what can be seen on the layers they affect. More precisely, they change the opacity of pixels on the layer they affect based on black and white values. If you paint with black on the layer mask, you'll make the pixels of your source layer invisible. If you paint with white, you'll push them back to 100% opacity. The advantage of layer masks is that they give you the ability to play with transparency in a non-destructive way. You can always delete a layer mask without losing your original work. There is no keyboard shortcut by default to add a layer mask in Photoshop. To add a mask, you simply have to click on the Add Layer Mask icon at the bottom of your Layers panel. If you have something selected, the mask will use your selection. And well, you can add a mask to a layer group in Photoshop, which is very handy. But there is more! You can actually use a vector shape as your mask. In the latest Photoshop versions, your layer needs to have a mask already. Then you need to go to the Properties panel. To bring it up, go to the Windows drop-down menu and select Properties. There are two icons at the top right of the panel. The first one selects your layer masks. If you click on the second one, it will add a vector mask based on the currently selected path. And technique number three, locking the layer's alpha. In Photoshop, you can lock your raster layer's alpha by pressing the slash key. This tool is great if you want to quickly paint within your shape without messing its alpha channel. You can still clip other layers to that base layer if you want. I like this option the most whenever I feel comfortable with a given art direction. If I need to give assets a painterly feel as well, I likely shade them with a traditional painter's approach, directly brushing on the layer. That's it for this video. Some of you may know that I delayed the second part of the mobile button video. I realized when I was writing it that it would be more interesting to explain the tools I use first. This way, when the video comes out, I can send you back to this general series on game art and focus on UI-specific techniques. I'll expand this series slowly with coloring tools, common layer effects, as well as some game art specific workflow techniques. If you like the video and want to see more, you can become one of my channel's subscribers. And don't hesitate to become a follower as well on social networks. Thank you for watching.